TSP, the traveling salesman problem, is the problem of given some n cities and the distances between them, finding the shortest cyclical tour that visits each city.
This is Jakub, a PhD student of the SC School at EPFL, and the problem he talked about, the traveling salesman problem, or TSP, is one of the most iconic problems in computer science.
Well, it's very easy to understand.
This is Ola Svensson, a professor of the SC School at EPFL.
For every person has like gone maybe on a railway tour in Europe or so on, and they want to find the shortest way to do that, or the cheapest way. So I think it's very easy to relate to.
So what's TSP? Given n cities, TSP is the problem of touring all cities and then get back to the initial city. And you want your tour to minimize the total traveled distance. Now, any such tour can easily be encoded by the order in which the cities are visited. So for instance, the tour that I displayed corresponds to the order Lausanne, Basel, Zurich, Bern, and then back to Lausanne. Now, with four cities, it's easy to test all possible tours. After all, assuming that we must start from Lausanne, the number of tours is the number of ordering of the three cities. And I'll let you check that there are six orderings of three cities. The trouble is what happens as there are more and more cities. Suppose we now have n cities. Instead of giving them names like Lausanne or Zurich, let's simply call them with numbers from 1 to n, and assume, without loss of generality, that our tour starts at city 1. The number of possible tours of n cities is then the number of orderings of the other n-1 numbers. Well, there are n-1 possible choices for the second city to visit, n-2 for the third city, and so on. In the end, the total number of possible tours is then the product of numbers 1 to n-1, which is commonly known as n-1 with an exclamation mark, also known as n-1 factorial. Now, 4-1 factorial is 3 factorial, which is 6, which is small. But 10-1 factorial is already around 300,000, while 100-1 factorial is way larger than the number of particles in the universe. This is if you test all possible tools, which is also known as brute force. Brute force is not an option to solve TSP. In fact, TSP is provably hard.
It's an NP-hard problem.
This means that if you find an algorithm that solves TSP efficiently, then you would be proving P equals to NP, thereby proving one of the 7 Millennium Prize problems. Now, most computer scientists actually rather believe that P is different from NP, in which case there would be no algorithm that always solves TSP efficiently. That's a bummer. So what can be done? Well, perhaps no algorithm solves TSP efficiently, but perhaps there are algorithms that almost solves TSP efficiently.
We are interested in what is the best approximation ratio that we can get in polynomial time.
So what's an approximation ratio? Well, the goal here is to design efficient algorithms that always score well at TSP. More formally, an algorithm is said to be alpha approximate if it always returns a solution that is at most alpha times the length of the optimal tour. And the fundamental question then is, what's the best possible value of alpha for polynomial time algorithms?
There is the special Euclidian case.
The Euclidian case is when cities are located on a two-dimensional plane and distances between cities are the usual Euclidian distance.
Where the problem can be approximated to arbitrary precision in polynomial time?
Indeed, in the late 90s, Arora and Mitchell independently proved that for any positive epsilon, there is a polynomial time algorithm with an approximation ratio of 1 plus epsilon. This discovery won the 2010 Gödel Prize.
But otherwise, its most special cases of this problem are hard to approximate.
In fact, in the most general case, no approximation ratio can be achieved by efficient algorithms.
If you don't assume anything about the distances, so say that the cost of going between city A and B can be completely unrelated between going to A to D and D to B or something like that, then we cannot do anything.
In other words, any efficient algorithm will hugely fail on some difficult instances.
So what you always assume when you want to derive algorithms for traveling salesman problem is that the distance satisfied triangle inequality. So if I want to go from A to B, that takes no longer than if I visit C on the way. So if I go to A, C, C, B, that takes no longer than going from A to B. which is a pretty natural assumption, or equivalent, you could say that I allow myself to visit several times the same city.
Yes, because if you want to go from A to C, you can always go through B, in which case the distance traveled between A and C is going to be the distance between A and B plus the distance between B and C. And thus, the shortest distance between A and C is going to be at most the sum of the distances between A and B and B and C, which corresponds to the triangle inequality.
So then we can do something.
There is a very easy two approximation, and there is a nice and also rather simple 1.5 approximation by Christofidis. This is a result from the 70s.
So we always guarantee that we are at most 50% worse than the optimal solution.
So we know that TSP yields a 1.5 approximation by efficient algorithms. But could there be a better efficient approximation of TSP?
It has still not been beaten. For unweighted graphs, we have a 1.4 approximation currently. But people believe this is far from what you can get. But we are short on the techniques to get anywhere close to one. Or
so the class of NP-complete problems that reduces all these open questions to one problem. Namely, if we can solve one of these problems, then we can solve all of them. So this shows that all the NP-complete problems, they're equivalent when it comes to efficient algorithms.
For the asymmetric triangle assessment problem, where the distances are not symmetric, so maybe it's much more expensive to go from U to V than to go from V to U.